scored so quickly.
12:29 to play, first quarter. Covey, the quarterback, Whittingham and Bellini, your backs, play action. Covey, plenty of time, throws back across the grain, looking for Bellini, makes the catch at the 42. He's at the 40, the 30, he may go. No one's going to catch Matt Bellini. And the Cougars, on the first play of their afternoon, score a touchdown. Bellini.
A defender slipped. It looked like he was reading the pass, and he slipped, and Bellini got in back of it.
Well, that's Matt Bellini's first touchdown by way of the airways. And Gifford, good play action. And Covey showed some strength in that arm to throw back across the grain.
Basically, what you've got is you've got a playback where everything is going to the left side of the field, and then Matt Bellini isolated on the right side of the field. It was Covey as he hit Bellini right in front of a defender. And then it was Bellini getting past that defender and going all the way for a touchdown. An outstanding call by the BYU coaches. Outstanding execution by the BYU offensive football team.
And the extra point is up, and it is no good. Jason Davis misses his first point after attempt of the season. So BYU takes the early lead, 6-0.
What can you expect when you invest at Schwab? Ask a Schwab customer.
I'm looking for quick response and accuracy. I call Schwab and often get my market orders confirmed while I'm still on the phone. I like the fact that there's no sales pressure. For me, Schwab simply delivers good service, good value.
For a free booklet, call 800-342-8100. That's 800-342-8100.
Excellent execution, like we said before, and they're off and running right now. I'm sure the BYU defense is going to be ready to come out and do it again.
Delaney and Petrie back to receive, and Petrie, number 10, takes the football, finds a little opening up the middle, and is tackled down at the 26-yard line. Good return there by Stanley Petrie.
The tackle was made by the kicker. Kaufman got down and made the stop. You know, when Bellini got open, he had a linebacker right near him, Scott Harris, and he just ran away from him. No linebacker is going to catch Bellini.
And remember, Jay, he's coming off some knee surgery again just, what, 3 weeks ago.
That's true. It's amazing how quick they come back nowadays.
Scotty Ankrum in, the quarterback, the Horned Frogs of TCU. And the handoff went to Bernarski, and he got stacked up, got a couple of helmets right in the numbers, and they will say no gain on the play, second down and 10. So we see that Jim Wacker is already switching his quarterbacks after Rasko was unsuccessful on that first series.
Well, this was not a very good read by Ankrum. The thing that you want to do in the running the wishbone is you want to come down and option the end. If that end closes, you want to keep the ball. That time, Ankrum kept the ball, or he handed off where he should have kept it. And consequently, BYU's defense was there to stop it.
Reggie Davis goes in motion. Ankrum wants to throw the football, zips one low, and incomplete at the 37-yard line. That ball bounced up into the arms of Reggie Davis. He's a senior out of Jasper, Texas. As we take a look at Lavelle Edwards, looking down the TCU roster, it's amazing how many Texas athletes stay home and play for the Horned Frogs.
Well, the Texas people feel like you don't have to go anywhere else in order to get what you want as far as a football team is concerned. You can see the scoring drive, 77 yards, just one play. The Cougars striking quickly.
So officially a 77-yard touchdown between Covey and Bellini. Third down and 11 for TCU. Davis again goes in motion near sideline. The handoff back at the 20-yard line. Timmy Knight there to sniff out that play.
He slipped as he took the handoff, and Knight was right on top of it.
D'Arthur got the football and lost his footing. So for the second time in a row, TCU forced to punt the football away. Chris Becker back in with a 41.5 average.
That shows you the contrasting style of these two teams. TCU with 11 yards to go for a first down with a draw play. You just can't get first downs when you run draw plays in that situation.
And Becker from his own 11-yard line lofts the football down to Rodney Rice at the 27, tries to work his way far sideline. Flags are thrown. Rice is pushed back and driven out of bounds at the 24-yard line, but we have a yellow hanky down at the 28.
And I think they're going to get Courtney Rogers for a clip. Rice was trying to get to his wall, going around the right side, and he kept losing ground. Courtney Rogers there trying to get a block. and he couldn't quite do it. You can see Rice as he gathers in the football. Now he's going to his right to try and get some blockers, trying to get some help, and it's Courtney Rogers right there as he clips. The official was standing right there through the flag as Rodney Rice goes all the way around. Can't get around the wall. Good punt protection and coverage on the part of TCU that time. They drop Rice before he can get around the corner.
And Buddy Wyatt there to put the wraps on Rodney Rice. That penalty gift will push the Cougars back to the 12-yard line.
Here you can see the starting offense for the Cougars. Franson on the outside, Cutler on the outside. Darren Hanley is the tight end. Covey will start at quarterback. Bellini and Winningham will start in the backfield. And then there's White, Rosenbark, Nawahi, Wheat, and Hunter. It's quite a team.
A lot of beef up front. BYU's front line averages in at 273 pounds. TCU's defensive front line, 262. Covey wants a throw, looking up top. He finds a man wide open at the 35-yard line. And tackled down at the 44 is Chuck Cutler.
Let's take a look at the secondary, and you can see why this pass was completed. Missing in the BYU passing game has been the intermediate routes. Now, this is a straight zone defense. You can see as Cutler comes inside, he cuts right in front of the strong safety, catches it before the weak safety. The weak safety runs past. Cutler gathers in the ball, and he takes it all the way down to the 45-yard line. And if you want to get out of a hole, that's the best way to do it.
Well, the Cougars have run two plays. They've passed both times and have gone over or nearly the 100-yard mark on just two pass plays. Covey on first down, out of the pocket. He's running to the far sideline. Football, heads up play, Covey. Nobody open, and he threw it out of bounds.
One thing that Covey's been able to do up to this point in the season is get outside. Not too many times will he be able to do that against TCU because these guys are very quick. Covey that time using very good knowledge of the passing game and throwing that ball out of bounds. He did not have anybody open, so he just threw it over the top of Franson's head. You can see Sean Covey's statistics so far for the year. And the thing that I noticed, Craig, is I noticed that he's up above 50% in completion percentage. And you, a couple of weeks ago when we did a game, it was only down to about 33%.
Second down and 10 at the 44-yard line. Covey on the quick hook pattern flips the ball far sideline at the 46-yard line, and the catch made there by Chuck Cutler.
You know, the WAC teams are very proud of their record so far against non-conference opponents. The top five teams are 12-0.
Here you can see Cutler on just what you call a quick spot pattern where he takes about four steps and then hopefully the ball is in the air. The ball was in the air, and a couple of weeks ago we saw Covey throw that pass and it was intercepted. That time he got the ball there on time.
Third down and 8. Two wideouts line up to the near side of the field. Covey rolls that way. Now back.
Oh, he's got it. He's got it.
Wide open. Hanley wide open at the 45, the 50. The big guy can run, and he barrels his way out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Greg Moore, number 44, the weak side linebacker there to make the stop. But the Cougars calling some big pass plays here, Giff. And Hanley showed some speed and rumbled down out of bounds.
A couple of offensive linemen are going to be absolutely sick when they see this play. TCU coming with the blitz. It was a screen back to the tight end. And a couple of offensive linemen for the Cougars missed their blocker. Hanley goes all the way for a touchdown. Nawahi and Brian White can't quite get their blocks. BYU has to punt.
Freddie Whittingham did throw a good block to help him get the pass away.
In to kick the football, Pat Thompson. He's got a heck of a foot. The ball taken at the 9. And the Cougars wrap. Put the wraps on number 1 for TCU. That's Olenda Newton. So with 9:18 left to play, first quarter, Cougars lead it by a score of 6-0. This is the Video West Network. If you just joined us, BYU struck first. Bellini on a 77-yard touchdown pass from Covey. The extra point was missed. 6-0. Ankrum keeps the football, tries to cut it upfield, and he is hit down at the 14-yard line. Johnny Ankrum. Total yards so far in this football game. BYU 118 yards. TCU add the 4 that Ankrum just picked up. They gained 20.
They got behind. They could have some problems. Their passing attack has almost been non-existent this year.
Every year.
Every year. Okay.
They don't like to throw the football.
Second down and 6. Ankrum fakes into the line. He fumbles the football, recovers it at the 11. And the Cougars' pursuit there, excellent. Chad Robinson, along with number 36, Bob Davis. Those two have teamed up, Jay, to have a whale of a good season.
They have. Robinson is an excellent football player. Watch, we can see him coming down the line. Number 9, he just sort of stays right with the football. Well, there's Bob Davis. Number 9 is Robinson.
But one of the reasons that Robinson was right there is because Bob Davis took the fullback, and so the quarterback has to take the ball out of the fullback's gut, and then it's Chad Robinson getting the quarterback, and Rodney Rice had the pitch man.
Back in this game is Rasko to throw the football, and he overthrows his wide receiver, Jared Delaney. And he didn't start this football game because of disciplinary reasons. He missed the team bus. And that time, Rasko, who had obviously, guys, cooled down a bit on the sideline, asked to come in and throw the football. That's a tough task.
Well, they'll put Rasko in to throw the football more than they will with Scotty Ankrum. Ankrum is the guy that runs the wishbone and runs effectively.
And for the third time, Chris Becker forced a punt. The punt is blocked, picked up by BYU, and touchdown, Cougars. That's...
It may have been Tia Tia, the 25, Sim Tia Tia.
Tia Tia. With a couple of white jerseys on his back, balls over the goal line.
You could see them coming as they lined up that time. They were looking for that.
An interesting note here, in the offseason, what they tried to do is they tried to get Becker to start kicking from two steps because of his future as possibly a pro player. That time he took too much time, and then watch Tia Tia. As he picks up the ball, he just gets in the end zone, but then he fumbles, but the ball is already over the end line. He gets the touchdown. Watch him as Tia Tia goes into the end zone. The ball's over the end line. It is a touchdown for BYU. Special teams, extremely important in putting together a game plan each week.
Skipper, it isn't often you see a BYU football team pushed around physically. Last year they were by TCU on the road. I'm sure we were thinking about that in the game here today. No evidence at all of that in this game.
There really isn't any evidence. And, I have to go back to the special teams play, and you talk about Becker. Coming into this game, we had the two top punters in the country, really, kicking in this game. Becker has slacked off this year from where he was last year. He was a preseason All-American, but during the offseason, the coaches tried to change him from a three-step punter to a two-step punter, and it really has messed up his rhythm as far as kicking the ball. And I believe that is the very first kick that he has had blocked in his career as a collegiate punter.
You know, Coach Wacker had said that he was an NFL-type kicker, Griff. If in fact, he said he could be kicking for NFL teams right now.
Well, once again, it comes back to three steps and two steps and feeling extremely comfortable with what you're trying to accomplish. BYU going for 2 points.
Gifford, they had called timeout, and after missing that first extra point after that touchdown by Bellini, they will go for two. Cutler in motion. Covey rolling to his right, throws back across the grain, cut by Cutler and dropped. Good coverage there that time by Christian. That's Stanley Petrie, the right side cornerback, up to make the play on Chuck Cutler.
The ball was tipped as soon as Covey threw it, too, I believe, and that's the ball from getting there a little bit quicker. Petrie is an interesting story out of Willow Ridge High School, a very good high school as far as football is concerned in the Houston area. If you guys get this, 4.35 in the 40-yard dash.
I understand he'd been a utility player for 3 years, and then in spring had a great spring.
Well, Giff, what does Wacker say to his club? You mentioned in the pregame show he didn't know what type of team or what team would show up today.
Well, I think he's finding out what team did show up today. You know, it's really tough with TCU's offense. They don't like to throw the ball. They've got outstanding wide receivers, but they don't practice on the throwing game. And you've got to do that in practice. I know at BYU, we used to go out and throw for maybe 30 minutes before we even would start practice. And you've got to continually do that in order to have an effective passing game. Well, TCU would a lot rather run the football in practice and run the football during games. And so it's extremely difficult for them to come back when they are down. One of the things, too, it takes up a lot of time when you're running the football.